In this video, we solve another circuit using mesh current method. And in this circuit, we have voltage sources, but one of those voltage sources is a dependent voltage source. This one right here, which has value 10I0. And actually, I forgot to put here ahead of time that I0, okay, which is the current that this dependent voltage source value depends on, is over here. Remember, that has to be defined for us. When we have a dependent source of any kind, whatever variable its value depends on, it's given in the problem. So I forgot to write that before I started the video. Okay, but now let's go ahead and solve this with mesh current method. So the first thing, we have three meshes in this circuit. There's a mesh here. There's a mesh here, and there's a mesh here. Again, if you think of the circuit as being a window frame, then the meshes are where the panes of glass go. Okay? So I'm going to define a mesh current in each of these meshes, and I'm going to choose clockwise, okay, like I talked about last time. So there's I1, and based on I1's direction, those would be the higher voltage end of the resistors that I1 goes through. Now I like to do my mesh currents in different colors here. I think it just helps with when you're writing the Kvl equation. So we'll do I2 red. Okay, so I2 is entering the 8 ohm there and the 2 ohm there. And then use orange for I3. That's our current right here. That's I3. Okay, so now we can write our KVL equations. And I'm going to start with, we're going to start with KVL, okay, for I1. So I'm going to start here at the 20 volt source. So as I'm going in the direction of I1, I'm going minus the plus in voltage across the 20 volt source. So that's minus 20. Then I get to the 4 ohm resistor. The 4 ohm resistor has two mesh currents defined through it. So it's going to give me two terms in my KVL equation. So going in the direction of I1, I go plus the minus. So that's a plus 4I1. Okay, then also going in the direction of I1, I go minus the plus in voltage due to I3. So that's minus 4I3. Okay, and then for the 2 ohm resistor, I'll get plus 2I1 minus 2I2. Alright, and that sums to zero. So that's KVL for I1. Now we have KVL for I2. I'm going to start here at the dependent voltage source. So as I go in the direction of I2, I'm going minus to plus in voltage. So that's going to be minus 10I0. Then at the 2 ohm resistor, I'll get plus 2I2. Minus 2I1. Then I'll have plus 8I2 minus 8I3, and that sums to zero. Okay, and then we've got KVL for I3, which is the top mesh. I'll start at the 6 ohm resistor. There's only I3 defined through the 6 ohm, so I just get 6I3. Then at the 8 ohm, I'll have plus 8I3 minus 8I2. Then at the 4 ohm, we're going to get plus 4I3 minus 4I1. Alright, so you see, very systematic. That's why they call it a systematic method. Okay, but when we're done with these KVL equations, You can see because of the dependent voltage source, we have an extra unknown here, I0, right? So we've got our three KVL equations, but we got four unknowns. We got the three mesh currents, I1, I2, and I3, and then we have this I0, which is a current that's defined over in this part of the circuit. So I need to come up with an equation for I0 equal to, you know, what I'm solving for, which I'm solving for mesh current. So if we look here, I0 is the current defined right at this part of the circuit. Well, at this part of the circuit, only mesh current I3 is defined where I0 is. So I0 just equals I3. So I just plug in I3 right here, and now I got three equations, three unknowns, and I can go ahead and solve. So I am just going to give you, let's see, what do I have here? I'm looking at my notes, and actually I don't think I wrote down what the values of the mesh currents were here. Looking real quick. So actually in the next video I will give you those values. I don't have them handy right now. But you would solve these equations like you've done in the past, and then once you have your mesh current values, you should be able to find all the currents, voltages, and powers for all the elements like we've done several times earlier for this method and node voltage method. Okay, so in the next video, at the beginning of that video, I'll put the values of these currents.